Now, due to the incredible popularity of the new Polaris Razor S, we've not been able to get our hands on one for a complete test. But thanks to our friends at XXX Off-Road and Bulldog ATV Products, we did get to spend just a little bit of time with their brand new S before they started modifying it with some of their products that they make. Now, the changes to the S do make it a much bigger machine than the regular Razor, and parked next to our already modified Project Razor and a stock Rhino, it'll give you a look at just how much bigger this thing actually is. Although most of the S remains identical to the standard Razor, there are a couple of pretty huge modifications. Of course, the most noticeable of those changes are the new A-arms front and rear that are 5 inches longer. Then, to these longer arms are mounted Fox Podium reservoir shocks with adjustable compression and rebound damping. Now, these changes give the S a stated wheel travel of 12 inches as compared to 9 inches for the regular Razor. Then, at all four corners are 26-inch Maxxis Big Horn radials that are mounted on 12-inch cast aluminum wheels. In addition to the handling improvements, the S has also been fitted with the HO engine that, thanks to a few internal tweaks and a dual head pipe, provides an additional 6% increase in horsepower. Now, basically, the new Razor S is a factory edition of what many folks that don't ride on 50-inch wide trails do to their Razors anyway, and typically spend a lot more than the additional $3,200 doing it. Our take, the power gain of the HO engine is mostly unnoticeable as it seems to be offset by the additional weight of the S package and the drag of the bigger and heavier wheels and tires. But, you know, that's okay as the Razor's not short on power by any means. The suspension is where all the incredible comments will come into play. And although only an additional 3 inches of wheel travel over a standard Razor, the fact is that every one of those 12 inches is far better dampened than the standard model. And you'll feel the difference on every whoop and jump that you come across. And if there's a downside to any of this, it's that you may just find that the S is more capable than you are brave. And if you are able to push the limits of the S, be forewarned, when you overdrive your ability, you're going to be going mighty fast. The bottom line, if you ride the open desert or play on the sand dunes or even race, you're going to be hard-pressed to find more performance for your dollar than the Razor S provides.